and welcome to my year threes for the next instalment of Violin with Mrs. Groom. And I am Mrs. Groom. So this week was all about this bit of the violin. Who can tell me what this bit's called? Yes, you're right. It's the bow. Yeah! So we're going to just quickly recap how we hold the bow. Now the bow goes in our right arm. We hold it with our right hand. And what I'd like you to do is take your left hand, hold the bow horizontally, use your left hand to hold the stick of the bow, and then take the right hand off and wave at me. Hello. And what we need to do now is we need to make this hand go all floppy. Now, if you make your hand go all floppy like this, I call it the sleeping hand. Can you see that all of our fingers are nice and bendy, nice and relaxed, our thumb is nice and relaxed, and that's how we start our bow hold. So what you need to do is you need to get your thumb and you're going to put it in this little groove just here. Not right in this bit, but in this bit here, okay? And then we're going to just wrap our fingers nicely around the top, just naturally. Now some of you have a little furry sticker to help you with that. So try and touch that furry sticker. If you don't have one, let me know on Thursday when I see you. So we're going to wrap the fingers around the stick and our pinky goes on the tip like that. Can you see? Just on the tip. So it's not going to fall off. And our thumb remains nice and bendy. So you should be able to see through a little hole where your thumb is and your hand is. And that is our bow hold. Now it can be quite difficult to hold the bow when we take our left hand away. And you will feel it in your little finger. It's quite heavy. So for the moment, just keep it there. But it is also easier to hold the bow this way around, so try holding it this way around, okay? And why don't you try doing some little exercises with the bow? Can you hold it like this and then turn it the other way around? We call this windscreen wipers, okay? So we're moving the pressure from our little finger to our first finger. Can you try that whilst keeping your fingers nice and bendy? And that's windscreen wipers, okay? Can you shoot a rocket, boom, with your bow whilst keeping your bow hold nice and steady? You can also try this with a pencil. Let me show you. So here's my pencil, and I'm going to find it exactly the same way. Okay, so take your pencil, hold it in the left hand, make your right hand nice and floppy, thumb in the corner, fingers wrap round just as they are, pinky on the tip. Just like that. So your fingers should be lower than your thumb. Can you see? Okay, and with that pencil, you can do seesaws, windscreen wipers. You could even try and draw little circles. See if you can do that. Keep your fingers nice and flexible, thumb nice and bendy. What we don't want to see is your thumb like this. Not so good. We need it to be nice and bendy like this. And the fingers nice and bendy. Keeping the fingers all together. So shouldn't be any of this, shouldn't be any of this, but just nice and bendy like this. Lovely. If you are in any doubt about any of that, I have given you a piece of paper that looks a little bit like this, and that tells you all about how to hold your bow, and it tells you the different parts of the bow as well. So we're going to recap that now. Okay, so the parts of the bow. As you know, we found out the other day that when we want to put the bow away, we have to loosen the bow. So remember, we're going to turn this little screw at the bottom to the left to loosen it. Lefty loosey, righty tighty. So we're going to turn it to the left, okay? And that should make your bow hair go all floppy. Don't know if you can see that. All floppy like this. And that's what we want, and that's how you put the bow away. To wake the bow up, when we want to play it, we're going to turn the screw to the right, righty-tighty. Okay, and we're just going to make it a bit tighter so that the hair comes away from the stick, like that. Not too far away, because we still want it to remain in the correct shape, but I would say so you can easily see through it. There's a bit of a gap, maybe a finger width's worth, okay? Another thing you should know about the bow is that you should never touch the bow hair. okay? And that is because, one, it makes it a bit greasy, because we've got greasy fingers. Some of you more than others, probably, have got greasy fingers. And the other thing is that we use something called rosin to help our bow grip to the string. Now, we talked about that in our lesson a couple of weeks ago, about what rosin does to the string. And that produces a white powder, and we need that on our bow. And if we touch the hair, we take that white powder off, and we also get sticky fingers, which isn't so good. So, once you've got your bow ready, and you've got your bow hold sorted out, just like mine, then we can go ahead and play. So, I've got my violin, and I've got my bow with me, and I've got some music. So my music this week, we looked at this music here in your Violin Star book. Okay, we've got Big Ben and Little Ben. And if you remember, Big Ben, we were using two different notes. Okay, the first of these notes is a G, and a G sits right at the bottom of our stave. Okay, we have to draw little lines above the note to tell us that it's a G, that it's quite low. Okay, the next note is a D. Can you see that? And the D hangs below the bottom line of the stave. So we need to know where those two live on our violin. So just remind yourself which one's a G and which one is a D. Could you remember from last week? The G string is the bottom string, and the D string is the one next to the bottom string. Lovely. And we're going to pluck this first. So can you get your plucking fingers at the ready? Make your fist, make your L shape, put your thumb in the corner, and we're going to pluck. We're going to play Big Ben together. Are you ready? How did you do? All right, we're gonna have a go now at Little Ben, which uses two other notes, our two extra notes. So can you remember the name of the two other notes, which other strings we have for Little Ben? Can you see we've got an A? Now an A sits on the second space up. Okay, and then our highest note is an E, and that sits on the last space. Now, if you remember from last lesson, we looked at all the notes in the spaces, and they spell out the word face. So all we need to know is that F sits in the first space, an A, which is the note we're about to play, sits in the second space, a C sits in the third space, and an E sits in the top space, and that's our top string. So we need our A and our E string for Little Ben. Can you play that one with me as well? Here we go. Get ready to play. Violin sitting on our shoulder, plucking fingers at the ready. E and A. Are you ready, Little Ben? How did you get on? I hope you did well. If you found any of that tricky, then go over it again, reread the music, listen to the backing track, and you should be fine. Okay, now comes the tricky part, because we're going to put in our bow to all of this. So, can you get your bow ready? Now, do you remember that we need to keep our bow between the bridge and the fingerboard at all times? So just place your bow on the string, and if you have a little look at Ready Steady Bow now. But before we do that, we're just going to have a go at playing some open strings with our bow. Okay, so can you find the A string, and can you play four long A strings for me, going right from the heel of the bow to the tip of the bow, like this. Just like that. And now see if you can do the same on the D string. Okay, so for that you might need a bit more space in your upper arm to come up to the D string, and we're going to have a go going from the heel to the tip. Are you ready? Do it with me. Lovely. And try and make sure that you're using the whole of your bow when you do that. So going right from the heel, which is this bit, to the tip, which is this bit. Okay, let's see if we can do the same on a G string. So you might need a little bit more air in that balloon to get your arm up, and we're going to reach to the G string. Are you ready? Four long bows. How was that? And last but not least, the E string. Now we don't need quite so much weight on this one. So just be really light with the bow, but again, go from the heel to the tip. Are you ready? Great. So you might have noticed that through that, I was looking at where my bow was. Now you might need to do the same at this beginning stage, just to make sure that you're playing between the bridge and the fingerboard, as sometimes we can skate over here to the bridge, to the fingerboard. And that's not where the best sound is. So really practice those long notes before you use the bow. Okay, now we're going to look at ready, steady, bow, which is the piece that I've asked you to practice this week. So try doing this with the backing track. Just so you know, within ready, steady, bow, let's just have a look at the music together. You might have got a bit confused, or you may have remembered how we looked at this before. We've got four notes in a row, and then we have a box which is empty with a box inside it as well. And that means that we're going to rest for four beats. So we're going to play D, 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 rest, 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 rest. And you might want to say rest in your head, or shh, 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 shh in your head. And then we go on to A. A, 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 shh, 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 shh. And then back to D, 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 shh, 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 shh. A, 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 A. Shh, 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 shh. Another thing you might notice about this music here is that we have some extra lines and some extra dots just here and here. Now these mean that we need to repeat that little section. So we go from the beginning and we go all the way through just like this, and then we get to where these lines and these dots are. And what that means is that we need to go right back to here and start again. Go all the way through, and then finish here. Are you ready? Get your violin up, standing up straight, with our violin being held on the shoulder like this, with our bow hold, with our nice relaxed fingers, and our bendy pinky on the tip, and we're going to play ready, steady, bow. How did you get on? I hope you did well. If you didn't manage that the first time, try it again. You might want to get mum or dad to come and help you play it with the backing track if you want to. So that's all for this week. Next time I see you will be Thursday, so don't forget your bow, your violin, your case, your book, and I will see you then.